Hello everyone, and welcome to the very first Fall Guys season reveal. And what a way to kick it all off. Adventurers, stumbling mummies, weird fruit pirates, and a mysterious stranger overseeing it all. And that is just the cinematic trailer. We have got loads to show you over the next 20-ish minutes, including an in-depth look at two of our brand new rounds, some never before seen artwork, and the exclusive reveal of the season 5 gameplay trailer. I'll also be making time to chat to plenty of folks from the Fall Guys development team with creative insights and juicy details about what's to come. In fact, here's one now. So let's get right to it, Bean fans, with our first guest, Fall Guys lead designer, Joe Walsh. Joe, that trailer, it is amazing. Tell me everything.
Yeah, I think we always love like making these cinematic trailers for the game. It's always one of the most exciting things, is to basically do absolutely anything you want. And we were really able to kind of distill that like epic quest for the crown in a brand new way. And I think that combination of adventure style, storytelling and like really, really colorful, vivid jungle exploration just feels like such a perfect fit for Fall Guys. There's so many iconic moments from films and TV about these like quests for treasure, and it feels like the perfect opportunity for us to combine with Fall Guys gameplay in a new way.
So, am I going to feel like Indiana Jones this season?
Yeah, that is exactly what we want people to feel like. It's against all odds, like devious traps, you know, new obstacles that you've never seen before, and the most valuable prize to all, the Golden Crown, right at the end of it.
And of course, we've seen the trailer, we've talked a little bit about the theme this season, but I know everyone's interested in what they can unlock. So what can they look forward to this season?
Yes, we've got another 50-tier fame path for everybody this season, which is going to take people a long old time to get through. And it's probably our most colorful one yet. We have like great adventurer characters that you can unlock. We've got set dressing, like there's an amazing palm tree that you can dress up as. And then we have kind of horrors from the deep towards the end as well. And so I think like it's going to be great not only to see people unlock them, but also to see how people combine them. I think some of the combinations of upper and lower halves are going to be the most ridiculous that we've ever seen in the world of Fall Guys so far.
I mean, I absolutely cannot wait. Unfortunately, we've got a trailer, so let's take a look. Okay, well that looked even better than I imagined, but don't worry, we've got a lot more detail for you. Joe, you're going to talk us through the fame path in a bit more detail now, aren't you?
Yeah, absolutely.
So talk me through the season 5 fame path.
Yeah, we always want to start people off with a really awesome costume, especially when they come with jazzy shorts like the treasure charter comes with. So I'm looking forward to equipping them straight away.
Definitely.
And then, yeah, moving on to the one I mentioned before, which is the tropical tree, which I think is one of the most ridiculous costumes we've done so far. I particularly love the coconut claws you can see on the sides there.
I have to say, for me, that is pure Fall Guys, isn't it? Just absolutely brilliantly ridiculous.
Yeah, exactly. It's just so fun to get to design these with the art team. And I think it's a camel. It could be a llama. I'm not 100% sure.
I'm feeling llama.
Yeah.
I mean, rhino tamer?
Yeah, that's a kind of throwback to the trailer and some more exciting rounds that we got to demo later on, which I'm really excited to reveal more for.
Okay. Oh, also Spelunker.
Yeah. So this is the first collaboration that we're announcing for season 5, which is Spelunky is coming to Fall Guys for the first ever time. We're really, really lucky to get to do these collabs. And I think it's an absolutely perfect fit for season 5.
All right. I mean, I love these patterns. They're, you know, for me, they feel very Aztec.
We've got some pity crowns in there as well for people.
Yeah. For the people who need them, you know, not me. For those who need them. Okay. I like this hat coming up. I like this and the puffy sleeves.
Oh yeah, the Cavalier is our Renaissance musketeer. I think some people like to dress up nice and fancy when they're playing Fall Guys.
Yeah, you know.
And yeah, Scourge of the Seas is our Sea Kraken. So it comes complete with a nice jazzy nameplate. But I think it's got some really nice touches, this costume. There's a zip on the front of it and an adorable looking pirate ship on the top.
Oh, that one's brilliant.
Yeah, it always makes me laugh.
That one, the mouth is great. Okay, so what, the 46, what's this one?
Yeah, this is our first like flying costume. We've hinted at doing these things before, but the djinn comes in two parts and yeah, you're essentially a fully flying genie. So anybody who reaches Fame 50 is going to get the full costume on that, which is looking pretty amazing.
Now I'm going to have to try and get there.
It's a long old grind.
I mean, that looks absolutely fantastic. Thank you so much. What a way to kick off the show today. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks very much.
Now, we've seen some of the rewards you could be grabbing this season, so it's probably about time we looked at the fiendish obstacles you'll be facing in your stumbling quest for the crown. So, who better to chat to about those fresh season 5 rounds than one of the team responsible for creating them, junior level designer Max Boyle. Well, hello, Max.
Hello, lovely to be here.
Now, I'm very excited to have you here because I feel like you're the person who knows all the secrets.
We definitely have a few secrets for these levels and I'm really excited to show them. So yeah, let's talk about it.
All right. Well, I mean, what can you talk about? Tell me whatever you can about season 5.
So in season 5, we've obviously tried to raise the bar from our previous season. Season 4 was a big, you know, we put a lot of love and a lot of work into it and we were proud of what we come out with. And obviously every season we need to come in and be like, what can we do differently? What can we do that's new? So this season we've got a good few new obstacles that should challenge players in different ways than we've done previously. One of those new things is our rhinos, which are our wonderful little AI creatures that will try and chase you around and follow you around and knock you out of the level. And you will have a little brief second to jump out the way before they hit you, but do bear in mind that when they hit you, they will fling you quite far.
I mean, I'm glad I've been forewarned about these rhinos. Very excited to have been told in advance about those. Tell me a little bit about how you wanted the player experience to be different this time around.
We definitely wanted it to be approached slightly differently from previous seasons, obviously, and we've really focused in, as said, on more ways to interact with the level rather than obstacles being something you avoid. So we've kind of flipped it on its head here and created obstacles that are more have versatility and usage. So with this, we really wanted players to approach levels with a bit more thought.
All right, I'm going to stop teasing you all because I know what you really want is just to see some gameplay. So Max has very kindly brought us some footage of some of the levels that you've worked on.
Yeah.
So, yeah, let's take a look.
So this is a Treetop Tumble, which is our new big 60 player gauntlet level. It's also one of our first levels where we've added entirely separate routes throughout the whole way through the level. So you can take the top path up those discs and past our lovely frogs. And it's faster, but more dangerous. Or you can take the bottom route as this player here is doing. And it's a bit slower, but it's a bit safer. There's also the usage of our new water here, which you don't want to get into for too long as it will slow you down. So it's very much a way to kind of like stay above water, if you will. And here you can see, you know, there's a balance beam. This is led back into the top path. If you fall down, then you're back into the water. Like, oh, unfortunate little bean. But there's also obviously always little drums hidden under the water to help you get through.
Oh,
and that leads into this lovely little arena section where we have two of our rhinos, which you really want to avoid, otherwise they will knock you off. But they are absolutely amazing.
Terrifying. They look terrifying.
But you know, like we've got to have some sort of, you know, new thing. So here's our, and then we've got our slime slides, which, you know, lead your way to the end. And again, there's two routes you can take here. You can go through this, like the slime slide and onto the next one, or you can take this huge drum jump, which will lead you over to the finish.
You made that sound far too simple.
And this is Lily Leapers, which is another 60 to 40 player level, which is more themed compared to our gauntlet. So there's a strong focus on using the drums here. And the main way we want players to approach this level, as you can see all these lovely bouncing beans, is to bounce through the drums and make your way to the end. So again, leaning into that player choice, we want players to have freedom as to how they want to approach the level. So here we've got the side routes, which are a bit shorter and, you know, give skilled players a reason to kind of like go through there. Or, you know, if players aren't comfortable with doing that, they can still take the central route. And if you fall off, it's no big deal. You can just hop back on. And we've even made it a little bit difficult. Some of them move, some of them are static, you know, really just trying to add just something to make players look at it and go like, oh, that's new, that's different, and, you know, approach the level different, so.
I mean, I'm really expecting some mid-air collisions in this one. This is gonna be.
Yeah, it's one thing to say, bounce your way to the end of the level. It's a whole other to get 60 players to do that. So, you know, you wanna watch out because another player might knock you off. And we come to this final section here where there's the skilled route in the center where, as you can see, some players there trying to zip their way through the middle. Or you can take the safer side route, which again is a bit slower. So it's really up to you as to how you wanna approach this level before dinging your way here across the end.
Oh, I have to say, I love how the levels look. They feel like more alive, I think, than I've seen levels look before.
Oh, I mean, as I said, I wish I could take credit for that, but that's all down to our amazing art team. They really make our levels look absolutely gorgeous and fantastic. So really big credit to them, so yeah.
Oh, well, very helpfully, that's who we've got coming on next. But before we chat to them, thanks so much for coming in. Who does not love a sneak peek of gameplay? So,
thank you for having me. I love talking about it. So, you know, it's great to be here. So thank you.
Medieval Mayhem, a wintry wonderland. The neon lights of 4041. And now, rip-roaring adventure. Every new season of Fall Guys brings with it a completely different feel. And that wouldn't be possible without the fine folks of the Mediatonic art team. Their imagination truly knows no bounds. So I'm jumping in for a deeper look with concept artist Ji Young and lead artist Nick. So lovely to have you both with me.
Thank you for having us.
Now, Max very helpfully led in, and we talked a little bit about how this season really does feel very different. It feels a lot more alive, a lot more vibrant than the last season did. So tell me a little bit about how you've made season 5 feel so distinctive.
So, I mean, that's our goal. Like every season, we want to make sure that what we produce and what we offer to the players is something that's visually different, and it makes them want to come back. And that's what we spend a lot of time doing, is theme exploration. Because that's really where we come as a team and make sure to find something that really works. And from there, we kind of create a little visual guideline, basically all your constraints. And from this, we create everything that you see in the game, like all the new levels, all the new beautiful obstacles, and obviously all the beautiful and amazing costumes that all of the team done. But you can talk a little bit more about how the theme exploration and the theme.
Yeah, tell me about that, because obviously you mentioned that there are themes that you start off with. So how do you get from a big concept into the actual beautiful details of the game?
Yes, that big theme of season 5 is adventure. So when you first think of adventure, there are loads of things in it. So we just have some swashbuckling adventure like pirates, and dip into the earth like Indiana Jones or like mummies. And there are loads of adventure as well. So we just collected all images and videos and some other explorations and just tried some other little costumes and some background stuff as well.
I love that you used the word swashbuckling, because that's exactly the vibe, yes. I get. That's totally it. Well, I mean, I'm really excited because you've actually brought with you some of the behind the scenes artwork, haven't you? So let's take a look at what you've got. Now, this is the actual work, isn't it, that led to season 5?
This is it. This is like, for example, these are some of the early sketches that were like, how do we make that adventure theme look for guys? Like, we still make everything look very different, but it's still in the same crazy world that is for guys. Like, there's some of the like, vegetation we have for this season, some of the background exploration. The colors, I love the colors. They look so amazing this season. Everything looks so fresh, so bright, so cozy. And the work that they've done, the team, is phenomenal. Like, it just everything clicks in together. Like this, for example, like how we work, as I was talking about constraints, we define the theme and we define the colors, and then everybody can like create the new obstacles within this constraint, and everything clicks together. You put in the level and it looks amazing. I love this one. This is the frog. It's an amazing concept.
I mean, it's so interesting as well, because you think of Fall Guys as such a colourful game, don't you? And yet you've still managed to find a new colour palette that feels exciting and different and like something we haven't seen before, despite me thinking that every colour that has ever existed is already in the game.
That is a whole job, but look at that. Like, it looks amazing. This is like final like screenshot of one of the levels. Every new season is a new challenge, but we love it. It's what we love doing.
Well, I mean, you've absolutely risen to the challenge. Ji Young, this is your area of expertise, isn't it?
Yeah, this is the muddy explorer, the hero of the trailer. You just can see him a lot in the trailer. And here's the pirates, the brothers of pirates. They are our favorite pirate. We like that set. They are just basically a pirate, but we mesh up two concepts of fridge and pirates. So the idea started with that pirate love lime, or like lemons, you know, so I just combined the two ideas and there we go.
Oh, it's so interesting to see the iteration, the mermaid, the different versions with the feet and then the tail. Oh, well, thank you so much. It's so exciting to see how the season came to life, because it does feel, you know, Fall Guys is a world that by now we all know and love, we're very familiar with it, and to see it feel so fresh, so exciting, so different, it's, yeah, really lovely to peek behind the scenes. So thank you so much for bringing that in.
We love like being able to come in and like showcase how we do things. It's that it's a bigger team than just the two of us, and we're so yeah. proud.
There are a lot of artists, yeah.
Like an amazing team. Love the team at
Fall Guys. Well, the two of you for coming in today. And of course, big thanks to the rest of the art team.
Thank you so much.
Well, I really hope you've enjoyed this special first look at Season 5, exploring the fresh new adventure theme, the wild selection of new rounds, and a quick peek at the dazzling array of costumes for those fashion-conscious beans. I know the whole Fall Guys team are super excited for you to dive in for yourselves when Season 5 officially launches tomorrow. But before we go, here's our brand new Season 5 gameplay trailer to get you ready for your next Fall Guys adventure. See you soon.